Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Cookies, and I'll be the first to admit, it's been a while. I've learnt a lot, most of which you see represented behind me on the screen. Today, I'd like to share with you a fun little project for us spoopy game VTubers. I know, I tend to make my characters in games resemble my VTuber as much as the game will allow, and I've found a fun mod for 7 Days to Die that lets us do just that. We can put our VTubers directly into the action. To get started, you're going to need a few things. Vroid Studio, or a VRM model. The Vroid Mod, by JustAlterr, on nexusmods.com. Unity version 20.22.3.29. And 7 Days to Die, version 1.2. The first thing we're going to do is export a bare-bones version of our VRM model. So let's head on over to Vroid Studio to do that now. Here we are in Vroid Studio, and we're just going to pop on over to our camera exporter, click the export, and now I'm just going to export my model. If anything looks funny to you, don't mind it. This is 11.3. I've been using it for years. I'm not giving it up now. Don't judge me. Save this guy somewhere you're going to be able to remember, because we're going to put it into Unity in a little bit. Go ahead and save. Once that's saved, you're going to go to Nexus Mods. Search out the Vroid mod. I know that it is on page 3, so I'm going to go straight there. Click on the Vroid mod. You're going to make sure it's by JustAlterr. So as long as it's JustAlterr's mod, this is the one you want. Once we know we have the correct one, and maybe we've stopped and given them some love because they deserve it, this was a lot of work on their part. I click the manual download, and I save it somewhere I can remember, and I go ahead and extract the file so that when I'm in Unity, it's really easy to access. Okay. So once that's extracted, it's going to look kind of something like this, and what we're after is this Vroid converter package for Unity. But we need the right version of Unity first. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to check my installs, and yep, I have it installed right here. So I know I have 2022.3.29. If I did not have this, I could click the Install Editor button from my Unity Hub, go to the Archive tab, click Download Archive. It takes me to an entire archive of Unities. I click the year I want, 2022, and just go down the list till I find the one I'm looking for. Install that to my Unity Hub, and bam, Bob's your uncle, you're good to go. So we're going to go back to our Unity Hub. We know it's already there. We're going to go to Projects, New Project. Going to give it a name, 7 Days Model, and create the project. Of course, it does have to be a 3D project, but I kind of thought that spoke for itself. Here's our Unity. It's going to take a minute to do its thing. Bear with us. Okay, once Unity is open and it's done installing all of its goodies, you can go ahead and click Assets. We're going to import a custom package. We're going to go to that download folder and our extracted version of the Vroid converter, and we're just going to open that Unity package. It'll take half a second. It'll do some stuff in the background. Then you're going to click import. You're not going to uncheck any of these boxes. They all need to be checked as far as I know. Import all those assets, all those goodies. And we're waiting again, because that's how Unity rolls. It takes its time, but it does great things. So once that is processed, the first thing we're going to do is go down to scenes. We're going to look for the Vroid converter scene. Double click that, and it's going to bring us to a reference, Jen. Look at Jen. She's here for height, so that we know how tall we want to be in game. And now we're going to go get our VRM model, and we're going to drag it into the Place Avatars Here file. It's going to process and do its thing. Contemplate life. And bam, we're in the scene. So now we're going to take a look at this. kind of check us out. How are we doing? Are we the right size? I could be a little taller, so I'm going to go ahead and click my scale. Go ahead and scale it up just a little bit. Make sure I've reset my position to 0, 0, and 0. Now I'm going to take a look, see if I am too tall. I am too tall. I'm more of a big sister than an aunt, so let's just shrink us down just a little tiny bit and go ahead and make sure these are all zeros again. Ah, that's more the size I want to be. Now I'm going to go to this first person offset. And we want this red line to be basically in the middle of our eye, and it is conveniently right there right now. And our next step, after we've done that, go up here, and we're going to export to VRM0. Unity is going to do its processing for us. Normally, we would select a spot if we were processing our avatar regularly, but this is all done inside Unity itself. So now we're going to go to avatars and whatever we called ours. And inside the exported folder, you're going to find a 7 Days to Die model prefab. This you can pop up here and we're going to take a look at that. And we're just going to have a look, and it looks like my eyes might be a little bit up too high. So over here on your inspector side, you're going to find the Vroid avatar metadata, and you can actually adjust the eye height and just kind of make sure it's right where you want it. Once we're done this, we're almost done, guys. We've got this. Here we are. We're going to go up to VRM0 again. We're going to click export. I don't do the upload because if I'm going to share my VRM with somebody, I'm going to know they're trusted, not just any random stranger. Because that's just a little bit strange to me. I mean, you can do this if you want to. If you do, think of it like VR chat. This is a model that anybody can get. There's no protections that I know of, so just be careful, guys. Just be aware. Be careful. So click export. Wait for Unity to do its processing again, because that's how we roll. And now in our exported file, we have a 7 Days to Die model Unity 3D file. This is the file we're going to put into the mod itself. Our next step is to go ahead and we're going to put our mod into our mods folder for 7 Days to Die. So go ahead and go to your Steam. Go to your game 7 Days to Die. Go to Little Gear. Properties. Installed files. And browse. That should take you to where your mods folder is. Once your mods folder is open in 7 Days to Die, you can go ahead, transfer over all of the contents for the Vroid mod. Open that up. Look inside, you're going to find the Vroid Converter Unity package still here. I want you to delete that by right-clicking delete. Now open up the avatars. And what you're going to do is you're going to take your 7 Days to Die model, that is your Unity 3D file, the one that's got those little tabby right here, and you're just going to drag him. Right into there. Now we're going to do a test. We're going to open 7 Days to Die, and we're going to see what happens. Still waiting, anticipating. Won't be long. Says it's initializing. Spawning. Well, that just looks like normal 7 Days to Die. And then we go ahead, we click the tab button. We've got a little people. There's my model. I forgot to take a thumbnail, so it didn't show up. But there I am. Use spring bones, first person aiming, first person hands. And there we are. We are in the game, guys. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. I appreciate you spending time with me. I appreciate you guys learning something new. And I hope you have lots of fun. All right, guys, it has been a slice. And remember to get in the game, and we'll see you next time.